Welcome back to Mission ADOMPossible. For those of you who remember Munchies, the Drakeling Beastfighter, who has successfully completed the first mission of this competition, she has of course now been passed on to the care of my esteemed teammates in the Team of Water in this year's ADOM Mission ADOMPossible, and I have in turn been entrusted with the responsibility of guiding Sturm Flut, our orcish barbarian, to success in a second mission. As it might not be all too hard to deduce from what you see in front of you, Sturm Flut hasn't had a great time in his previous attempt to solve the first mission. In fact, this is the second incarnation of Sturm Flut. As far as the rules of the competition go, characters that die in the line of duty can be regenerated and can attempt the later missions from scratch. Meaning they start from the beginning of the game and can go directly for the second mission. In exchange, however, they have a severely reduced turn limit. Long story told, you can, of course, examine the specifics in the ADOM forum as usual. This means, essentially, that I have 9,000 turns playing in various dungeons, I can't visit all the locations, to kill myself a steel golem. If you don't know what a steel golem is, you are a lucky guy indeed. Anyway, enough dawdling, enough delays, let's get on with it, shall we? Now, let's first examine this guy's inventory. Like all orcish barbarians, he starts with a respectable starting armor. Nothing out of the ordinary, just an orcish helmet, some studded leather armor, and heavy boots. Yep, everything absolutely normal, which is of course a bit disappointing because there's a good chance usually for orcish barbarians to start out with much better PV than this guy has. I already noticed that part of the problem that might have led to his untimely demise in the first mission is located here. A strength of 21, toughness of 19 are very respectable for any character, but kind of on the low end for orcish barbarians, so it's pretty unlucky roll. Munchies had much better luck on that note, on that score. And the learning of 11 is exceptionally high for an orcish barbarian, which is a bit unfortunate because even for all the stats that went into learning, this guy still can't read because orcish barbarians, even if they cross the threshold of 10 learning, do not actually get literacy. All of that is now only marginally interesting, so let's proceed. Now, the first step, because the orcish barbarians, as you might be aware or not, do not start with healing, is to proceed to Terranio and get myself a healing quest. And that means I visit this guy, Rint, to make sure that Jowd exists. I will also seek out the tiny girl, because I might want to visit a dungeon. Unfortunately, she's not... Ah, there she is. Thank you, I am a nice barbarian. I would like to inquire about the location of your little doggy. Yes, maybe I will get her back, maybe I will eat her, I have not decided yet. Anyway... Where are we going from here? Ah, yeah, that's right. Lavanilothil. You enter a derelict and muddy settlement populated by equally derelict and muddy persons. I haven't seen Lavanilothil on YouTube for a while. Let's check out this place. Who's that guy? That seems to be a beggar. Please, some money, please. I'm not sure. How much money do I have? I want to keep it. I'm sorry, I'm just a bitch sometimes. I'm just a dick like that. I get a distinct impression that guy behind me is trying to start something. Not the best choice he's ever made. I can tell him that. I'll tell you that. I will eat him in retaliation. That's what I call poetic justice. And identify some items in this shop. It's a little sad that I can't afford any of them stuff in here. Potion of boost is okay. Oh. If only I could actually pay for those. I have to keep this in mind. These penetrating qualls, the penetrating affix bypasses a creature's PV, and the greatest challenge in killing a steel golem is the fact that it has 35 PV out of the box, which you have to get past to do any damage to it. And a bundle of 19 penetrating qualls is a major windfall in that regard, if I can manage to afford it. I'm not sure I really want to risk robbing a store, especially not with a level 1 character. The rest that's in the store is not particularly remarkable, but definitely, most definitely, have to keep a lookout for crossbows of any kind. Oh, the beggar is trying to attack me. Well, that's weird. Anyway, what I came here for in the first place, apparently Hotzenplotz no longer wears pink. The crime lord, do me a favor. Kill that annoying healer living to the northeast. He's so annoyingly goody-goody. I can't stand him. You also could do me another favor. Kill a damn sheriff in Terrigno. Such an annoying guy. I'll do you a favor if you succeed. And believe it or not, that's what I'm actually after this time. I mean, this time I am playing a thoroughly correct character, so I have absolutely no moral compulsions about this. Which is a good thing, of course. So let's get straight to the point. Village dungeon. Decent enough place to get a couple of levels in, though even with a relatively modestly statted orcish barbarian, I'm not really scared of the early game at all. Right out of the bat, I get a climbing set drop, which is marginally useful, I guess. I'm not sure yet, but I'm just picking up anyway, because why not? And now I would like to... Oh, this just pisses me right off. Oh, come on. I really don't have the time to spare to get bogged down not finding secret doors and stuff. Oh. For a moment there, I thought it was a doppelganger. I'm guessing playing orcs was just generally going to have that problem in a tile set based mode. You don't really... Huh? Ah, I see. It was from out of line of sight. That's quite a throwing arm. Anyway, I don't really want to waste time here, because my main goal here, apart from now finding a crossbow to use those quarrels with and gathering the gold to buy them, is to get to level 12 in any way means possible. At level 12, my class ability Tremendous Blow is activated, which triples the damage I do on a single hit in exchange for a massive increase in energy cost. Basically, I do triple damage, but it takes 4 times as long to recover to time for the next attack. This is still an excellent trade-off against monsters with very high PV, because I can combine essentially 4 hits together to form one really big hit that only has to defeat PV once. I will do much more damage that way, and will actually have a solid fighting chance, even if the quarrels thing doesn't pan out. But enough about that. It's level 2 is the first step. Hopefully one of many. Though 71,000 XP is a tall order, I have to admit that. And to reach it, I really can't waste more time than absolutely necessary in the village dungeon, so I have to get to VD4 as quickly as possible. I'm planning to do the puppy cave after that, and visiting the vault at the bottom, because it usually has a lot of creatures at a very small location, which means I can kill a lot of creatures and get, hopefully, a lot of XP. I'm already disliking the fact that I seem that the downstairs seemed to be all at a, in the last place I could possibly be looking. These dungeons really have two low-level monsters to be really worth exploring. So that's a bit of a downer. Yeah, I don't want to waste time with that guy. It's a corruption trap. That's not horrible yet. That's a rattling archer. These guys sometimes drop crossbows, but in this case I did not get lucky. Still. Good things come to those who wait. I see he's picked alert, so I'm gonna go for miser. I really want the crossbow drop. And that might make it marginally more likely. Yeah. Okay, more to the point, I just really don't want to think about this stuff. I always pick pressure hunter. Just so I don't have to think about it. Anyway, where are the down staircases? This is kind of pissing me off. Though in retrospect, I really should have looked that way first. Yeah. My map detection senses have been a little bit dulled. Because I haven't been playing all that long. For a while. Ringmail actually has the same defensive stats as standard leather armor, so I'm not even gonna bother. Could be trapped in any kind of thing. But at least I've already found this guy. I'm not gonna kid around with it. Let's not kid around with this. Great! I got what I came for. What's this in the corner? It's fortune cookie. Wonderful. This guy could drop... it was a white worm. Good thing I found it quickly and killed it quickly. Though, I'm not really planning on revisiting this place anyway, so... it is of no consequence. Dun-dun-dun-dun. I have to hike all the way across here to get to the down staircase again. That's level 4. Very good, very good. Still no crossbow though. Let's get some herbalism training in. Maybe a little more first aid. Right now it's not really relevant, but it might become relevant at some point in the future. Right. Back to Lavinilothiel. Because I have now killed a damn healer. Visit a doctor. He might do you a favor. The sheriff still seems to be alive. Change that. No, don't really have the time to spare for that particular quest. But where is a good doctor. Kranfneest. I like his sprite. He looks suitably mad. Arts and blood send ya. Okay, if he wants me to do you a favor, he'll know what might be best for you. Kranfneest, the mad doctor, suddenly pricks your skin with a needle. You feel unable to move. He removes your orcish helmet, puts a strange helmet on your head, touches a jewel on the front of the helmet, you lose consciousness. You wake up again. Now, I've successfully woken up, and I have this goodie to show for it. Healing skill of 60. Isn't it wonderful? Let's put on my helmet again. Where's my helmet? Oh, Jesus Christ. Where's my helmet? Will you stop already? Confusion. I want my helmet back, you fucking idiot. I don't do this very often, so I didn't quite remember. Step off my helmet. Thank you. Jesus balls. Right, so I have healing. That took me only about 1500 turns. Just over 7,500 to go. This is going to be a bit of a marathon episode, I'm afraid. because I'm not really planning on doing this in several sittings. Main purpose anyway is documentation. Hexagonal key, excellent, excellent. I don't really want to dig around in PC1, not enough wonderful creatures here. If I want to gather experience at a fastest rate, I'm gonna have to save lots of turns that I can spend in a big room killing hordes of creatures. Or generally counts of chaos are not wasted on danger level 1 puppy cave. Link Thief, unfortunately, will not usually have a crossbow. That's one something for rattling archers. I'm not sure, but there might be a minuscule chance that the puppy cave vault might contain rattling creatures, which would be a huge windfall for me, because in that case I would be able to collect... How did I not see that coming? Seriously, I must be as huge as... God. I can't allow myself to get too complacent like this again. It's almost killed me against the claw bug. I'll have to hope that I find some way of getting rid of that, those gauntlets again. So pretty much the only way I can think of is getting it rusted away by a rust monster. Oh, hey! It's a room full of XP! Yes, come here, little goblins, come here. None of you can do any damage to me anyway. Warm cloak, box of flint and steel, orange potion. Pile of goblin snacks. I'm gonna take the rest with me, I didn't buy rations, so whatever. Probably a good idea. Let me saturate again, I can eat another goblin snack. Some gold here. I think I'll definitely have enough gold to buy that stack of quarrels. Everything I need after that would be the aforementioned crossbow. And I almost forgot that Puppy Cave 5 is also a cavernous level which has a high monster generation rate, so this should be a good place to get some even more levels in. At the very least, I'll probably not going to starve in here. Starve? Pronunciation. It's a tough thing. This guy is a rattling warrior. Still not the kind of rattling I want. It's a rattling archer. Oh, I really have to get rid of these gauntlets sometime soon. I have one watery potion. It might be holy water, but a chance is too little to risk. I am a huge idiot. I'm only lucky enough that I'm still at a... that my strength is just high enough that I'm still at a even plus 0 to hit. Thanks to my weapon skill, I can still marginally fight. But one thing's for sure, those gauntlets are gonna kill me if I ever make it to the if I am to make it against the steel golem. In the long run, it's unacceptable. Unfortunately, because I'm chaotic, it's not gonna be all that easy to find a proper altar to make holy water with. And it's time to get a lot of XP. It's not totally terrible, I guess, the thing with the gauntlets. It also means that I'm at a very, very good armor rating at the moment, which is helping out a lot. Just not enough to make up for the downside of not being able to hit anything. Now, Treasure Hunter should maybe allow me to find a lot of items from... Oh, Christ. This has been really terrible. I suffer massive to-hit penalties for fighting surrounded. That should make it a little bit easier. Let's retreat over here. Yeah. I can hit them somewhat easier. And it won't take quite so long anymore. I have to pick a ranged weapon if I want to kill that floating eye safely. I've got a couple of rocks, that should do just the trick. Or I'm just gonna risk it. Oh dear. I am not, in fact, poison resistant. This could end poorly. I'm gonna be fine. I'm not gonna die to poison. Who dies to poison? Wusses do. Anyway, let's go down to the vault level. Shadow centipede. And it's a orc vault. That is actually pretty good. Orcs are easy to kill. There isn't really anything dangerous in an orc vault. It's just gonna take some more turns to actually get through. That's level 7. I'm part of the way there. Unfortunately, the XP scale is exponential in nature, so it's gonna take a lot of more XP to actually reach level 12. And the much-needed tremendous blow. Let's get some more herbalism up in this bitch. I have to say, playing an orc, you look basically identical to the regular orcs. It's hard to keep them apart. Well, I won't have to worry about food. Just beam me up, Scotty Skull. If it's uncursing, I'm really lucky. Though even if it is uncursing, I can read it for quite some time. Well, that's not that interesting. I want to... That's a crude spear. Like the one I'm already using. But it's never too bad of an idea to have a replacement. Die, all of you. Yes, you too. Especially you. Your face is especially ugly. You don't look too bad. That's a mithril cap, which is going to be lighter than the orcish helmet, so I'm going to pick it that instead. Massive clay potion of booze, what's here? Another mithril cap, of course. Why would I be getting new things that might be, you know, useful? A long spear, which is an item type that was introduced in ADOM 120. There are no long spears in the regular game, unfortunately. Though I do not know as of yet how good long spears actually are. Well, this one's made of mithril, so that's especially good. A mithril long spear. Well, it's two-handed, that's not too good. But I don't have a shield anyway. I've actually found some shields, but I was too stupid to remember to pick them up. So I might just as well go for a long spear. I should not be strained at this stage of the game with an orcish barbarian, really. I should have more than enough strength to carry, I don't know, ridiculous amounts of stuff. This is really kind of disappointing. A bad roll on an orcish barbarian. Goes to show, not every game can be easy. Well, I'm also carrying unreasonable amounts of orc of snacks with me. I quite like to wear a cloak. It's cloak defense, that's a good thing. Core Reckless, I have no idea what it does. Can't be too bad. Leather Girl is a girl of carrying. It's gonna be easier to get its stuff accommodated now. There's a mithril warhammer that's not really much better than the orcish spear, though. I can wear it with a pretty good wooden shield, actually. That should help. Yeah, I'm all set. Well, let's keep going. Nope, nothing to worry. Nothing very useful to see here. Let's get some more orcs killed. Slayer of your own kin, you have received another level. I want to kill some more potential family. That guy looked like my aunt. I hated my aunt. Oh, you're not going to run away. Oh, apparently you can reload with lumps of clay and use them as missiles. And I'm guessing if you're not a mist elf, that's just about the best use you're going to get out of those things. Only mist elves can use it for white necromancy. Okay. It's a holy symbol. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that. But I am a little bit of a pack rat at the moment. That's another scroll that could potentially be a scroll of uncursing. Very useful. Potentially. A sling. It's not really what I'm looking for, but I'll take it. I've got a couple of rocks anyway. It's a seed. Which might be an herb seed. Or herb seed. Whichever way the pronunciation goes. And I'm just about done with the vault at this point. I might as well look for the puppy dog corpse now. The danger level of this dungeon is pretty high, so exploring should be worth my time. Oh, I hope so, at least. Ooh, what's going on here? It's a werewolf. Wonderful. Come here. We've got something to talk about. Oh, don't you dare. Don't you fucking dare. I'm gonna kill these wolves and then I'm gonna find you and I'm gonna murder your ass. Don't you dare summon more of these fucking things. I mean, the experience is nice. I'm not too far away from level 9. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be able to make it to level 12 before the time limit is out. I've barely crossed a third of it. Where's the werewolf now? Come on, it's supposed to be feral and I don't know. Certainly fearless. What? Aw, come on. I keep forgetting I can't keep them from running if I just shoot them. I am a terrible ADOM player right now. Oh, of course he summoned more of the damn things. Oh, god damn it. Think of the XP. It's always nice not to have to walk too far. There you are. Wolves would also be edible, but I'm way too full anyway. I haven't yet had to eat a ration at all. I appreciate the constant... I really appreciate the constant wand finds. Once might be one of the things that can help me out against the steel golem. Something like a lightning wand, anyway. Berserker. That's, I think, a chieftain or something. A spear trap. Nothing too impressive. Come here. Carrion crawlers. They have a huge number of weak attacks which clutter up the message buffer. Carrion crawlers, I don't think, give me poison resistance. I'm gonna just not eat them at all. Cave lizard. That hellhound gave me level 9. I already have Mighty Blow. There's a remote chance that I might be able to do it with just Mighty Blow, but I don't want to rely on it. Especially not as long as I'm still stuck with the other... Chaos Gauntlets of Elemental Peace? Wow, it's way too late for me to even playing this game. What am I doing? The Gauntlets of Eternal Peace. That's what I have to get rid of. Okay. Now, what's going to be the most useful against a steel golem of the stuff in here? I'm tempted to pick good shot to make the quarrels count for something, but I have not even managed to find a crossbow yet, so that might be a bit too optimistic. Still, it's a legitimately good skill, but I'm going to go with quick for now, because the steel golem is one of those monsters who are stuck at exactly 100 speed. So if I'm slightly faster than that, I should be able to outrun it, which is especially important when it comes to my plan of shooting it with quarrels. So quick is definitely a good choice here. It's also my second to last talent, assuming I make it to my target of level 12, but I am now officially down with the puppy cave. I have to relocate at 4,500 turns. It's going to be half time. I don't really have that much time because I definitely have to get to Dwarf Town before that turn point is reached. And I've already noticed the last time that that can be a bit of a struggle. Mithril Broadsword, not quite powerful enough to use yet. It's at 1d7 plus 4, my Orcish Spear is at 1d8 plus 2. Unless I have an altar that can tell me whether I can actually use it. Not worth the try. Whether or not it's uncursed or not, it's not worth a try. Anyway, that might have given me fire resistance. I actually would really love to know if it has or not, because fire resistance would be a major asset against a steel golem, because he uses a fire-breathing attack that does considerable damage. I'm lucky in that regard in that I am playing a Orcish Barbarian with a decent toughness score that was actually increased 2 times, so since the beginning. It's now sitting at 21, which gives me a very respectable HP score that should go up to about 140 if I actually do reach level 12. And that gives me a little bit of a leeway against the steel golem. He won't, hopefully won't one-shot kill me, except if I get really unlucky, which, of course, is something that's always in the cards in this game. Right. Next step from here is buy myself the quarrels in Laurinilithiel, because those are just too potentially useful to pass up. It's even 19 of them. That's really good, actually. Now, let's hear here. Potion of invincibility dropped here. Not too impressive. I'm gonna take that stack of regular quarrels from the shop, too. Here's the stack of penetrating quarrels. The scale mail I'm not gonna buy. It only has 1 PV over my current armor, and it carries a significant penalty in DV. And there's still a shop at Waldenbrooks that I might want to buy out. So I'm gonna hold on to that gold. Food's not a problem. I picked enough of that during the adventure, so I can actually go straight for the cave. And because I remember that Sturm Flut initially died when he tried to cross some swamps, I'm gonna take a different route entirely. Take the shortcut across the river. And this way, avoid the swamps. Anyway, I'm still gonna reach the Caverns of Chaos in no time. There we are. Right. So, next target is Dwarf Town. I just have to see what I can find along the way. Treasure Hunter's gonna work for me a little here, but in the end, I am, as always, at the mercy of RNGesus. I'm actually really optimistic about those quarrel accounts. I have a lot of them, which means everything that stands between me and some significant missile combat goodness is an actual crossbow. That's another scroll that could be uncursing. Very good. And jackal, that is good for eating. And here's the door that leads to... That's a black hurfling. Yeah, those guys look funky. Unlabeled scroll, which could also be Scroll of Uncursing. Very important, don't confuse unlabeled with blank. Unlabeled scrolls could actually do something. And the blank scrolls could have a label. The game is rather inconsistent about this. Though that's part of a charm, that you never know what something is and what it isn't. Nothing in this room to see or find. The down staircases are here. Right, level 2. Here we have an altar. This one's neutrally aligned. Actually, I have a little bit of an idea on this one. Just for extra paranoid safety, I'm gonna drop my most valuable items, which in this case are the quarrels. Those are really my only really valuable items. Well, I guess I don't want to be losing those potions and things. Oh, I forgot to deliver the cute dog. This might come back to haunt me. I should probably get rid of it before too long. And use this altar. I really hope the mechanics of this haven't changed, because otherwise I am fucked. Let's sacrifice myself one gold piece at a time. I mean, it used to work. But I'm currently skeptical if it still does. You used to be able to get yourself to neutral alignment pretty quickly this way. Once that is achieved, I would be able to easily make some holy water. But it doesn't really look... Ah! No, it still works. Welcome, believer! Yes, I am now worship the one who kills instead of the one who rages. I'm not sure of the differences, but then again, I am not inundated in orcish culture and orcish theology the way Sturm Flut, I'm sure, is. So, praise the one who kills. Yeah, that's a guy, that's his name. The unfortunate side effect is that I no longer have my starting prayers, but if this here works as intended... I hit return. Oh, I see. It used to be that you could just hit return to sacrifice all of your gold, but at some point someone complained that misclicking and entering enter would just get rid of all of your gold instead of none of it. And they really hated losing all that gold, which I guess I can understand. You now have to actually consciously want to sacrifice all that gold. The one who kills seems to be pleased. That unfortunately is not enough. I have not been to a shop yet, but I do have a relatively valuable item here. And the one who kills happens to really enjoy gifts of melee weapons, so I'm gonna keep doing that. He's still only pleased though. A replacement Coot Spear? Also nice, but still not quite enough. Okay. That just means I'm gonna have to look for more gold. Luckily, there's the arena in this area of the map. It's an arena. And in the arena, I will be able to... let's just throw some clay at the stupid thing. In the arena, I will be able to earn lots of gold that should enable me to get in good enough standing with my god to bless the water and finally uncurse the gauntlets, so... I'll mark that down as a problem that is essentially solved. That is just not nice. And I really was essentially really asking for it because I didn't drop my items before I opened that door. Then again, I am operating on a turn limit, so... Maybe on those terms it's defensible. Or maybe not. I mean, I don't play this game perfectly by any stretch. I never have. Just might be a bit better at not making deadly mistakes than the average person. And little more matters in the end. Okay, let's kill some stuff in the arena. I'm thirsty for some blood. Yeah, not really. Okay, mostly I'm just thirsty for gold. To be honest. Right, Dak, the Arena Master.
Us is always looking for new talents. Talents to fight in arena and become rich and famous. Art ye interested? Ask me if ye want to mutilate some bodies. What's war, Sturm Flut? Want to fight? You have to win a test fight to make sure it's worth some gold.
Okay, what's the big scary... Oh, come on! Now, that's just insulting. What's also a bit embarrassing is that it took so long to actually kill that thing. Anyway, it dropped an iron ration. I have no idea how it got it, but there it is. And I get loads of gold from this shit. This is awesome. Giant rat, always tasty. There's a hobgoblin. I'm pretty confident I can kill anything here in here straight up with very little effort at this point. Which really should... If there's just in the world, that should mean that I'm gonna die in the arena, because I'm way too confident, way more confident than is entirely healthy in this game. You always die in unexpected places. Then again... Let's make more of this than it actually is. Oh, don't run. I don't have, really have just four turns to spare. I'm already across halftime. And I'm still quite a way away from level 12. It's going to take some lucky... Now I have to spend all that time getting rid of rats. By the truckloads. Those golems return piece are costing me valuable turns. Still, it could be worse. I could be watching a mermaid melody fend up. Always in tune with current internet culture. That's my watchword. Dang, how old is that joke? How old am I? What am I doing with my life anyway? Killing monsters in the arena, one after another. And then no challenge at all. Oh, wait. This guy's actually dangerous. He has a pretty powerful acid attack. Which he can't seem to actually land on me, so I'm lucky as far as that goes. Dang, the damage on these elements of these gauntlets. Well, though in this case, a part of the problem was that Ankex also have a pretty high PV score. So I didn't really get a lot of damage past it. The big chunks of damage that were taken out of it were essentially critical hits. 8 more fights. I'm just here for the money! Stupid... That gauntlet equip is gonna come back to haunt me. I can already feel it. Quasits look ridiculous. I mean, I'd never had a mental image of what a Quasit looks like, but this guy just looks... He essentially looks the way he sounds. Just a miserable little imp-like demonic creature. Except instead of an imp, it's a horned parrot. I'm not actually complaining. I like the way Quasits look. A minotaur wearing a scimitar. Oh, I'm not judging. But don't they usually drop great axes at some point sometimes? I might be misremembering things. Oh, wonderful. Oh, what the fucking treat. Thank you such much. So much. Oh, come here. Come here, you fucking jackal weir. I hate you so fucking much. How much TXP do these give per pop? 18. I get 18 XP for one of these stupid things. And here I am. Taking several turns to kill one because of the stupid gauntlets. Holy crap it. I mean, I'm still not in danger of not making the time limit, but... Oh, one of them ran away. Wonderful. Okay. 4 more fights. Okay. What is it this time? Just a giant lizard, that's good. Three more fights. This one's a fire lizard. If it drops a corpse, I really love to eat it. I took some considerable... Was that fire damage? You are burned. Yeah, that was fire damage. So I don't think I have fire resistant because there was relatively a lot of it. Two more fights. That's the last one I'm doing because... Whoa! Oh, we got out on the wrong foot. Let me fix that. Thank you! Right, with this gold it should be a cinch to get to very pleased status. But I'm not turning around for the altar. I'm just going to go straight to Dwarf Town because Dwarf Town will also have a neutral altar, which is good enough. Okay, there are herbs on this level. This is good to know. I'm actually going to get some major benefit out of herbs, especially mortar roots if I find more of them. Oh, there's a statue here. It resembles a young Arcadian boy accompanied by what appears to be a stuffed tiger dog. Aww! Riding together in a small red cart, the statue seems to be constructed of multitude of nondescript items. Man, I love that comic. So whoever put that statue in there, props for major nostalgic value. Hooray for Calvin and Hobbes. That is... Let's check herbalism. Withered. Yeah, I'm not gonna touch those. I might kill the bush and then I don't have the stable herb square. If it's a herb square with more... I'm not sure what herbs, kind of herb square it actually is in any way. Is that withered? 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 If I had a pickaxe, I could... This could be a stable herb square with only... with. All I would need is a pickaxe to get that wall away. So I'm not going to touch those herbs either. That's a corpse fiend. Those look ridiculous too. Cave tiger. I killed Hobbs! Oh damn. Check on water potions. Those are pretty sure those are uncursed water potions, so I really do need the altar and such. Oops, here. Grey ooze and hippogriff. There's a torch here. A vault on dungeon level 5. That could be worthwhile. If it's a mixed vault, I might make a good headway on my experience points. Or get killed, one or the other. If it's a rattling vault, that's essentially a jackpot, because that would give me almost guaranteed the crossbow I really need. Oh, it's undead. Could be worse. Is it, though? Yeah, definitely undead. With jackals mixed in. So it might not be undead at all, because all those jackals hint at the existence of a jackal weir. And jackal weir and undead in one vault would be... Oh, that's a good shield. A mixed vault, which on dungeon level 5 is not actually too bad, because they aren't that dangerous on low danger levels. No, definitely undead. There must have been random monsters there. Yep, definitely undead. Luckily none of them are really that dangerous. I have enough PV that I can fight even ghouls relatively safely. That's level 10. We're still a lot of experience points away from level 12, but it's not out of question that I can reach it before the end. It's a Fletchery set. I don't have Fletchery, so I'm not going to be using that. Some more potential... Uncursing... Food. I'm going to pick the melon because they don't weigh much, but... I'm full up on food at this point, so... Hey. I'm actually at a point where I can hit pretty well even through the reduction caused by my gauntlets. Found plenty of studded leather armor at this point, but nothing really better. Scale mail is only marginally better. Not even that much work bothering me with. Lumps of clay, I think, sell pretty well, so should hold on to them. Mercury potion. Potion of insight would be good because it would tell me for sure at a later date if I managed to get fire resistance. Okay, I know what a Ficador must be. 2/3 of the turn limit are over, actually, in other news. So I should try and make it to Dwarf Town relatively quickly. Yeah, that's a secret door. No more distractions. We are now in the big room. Let's try and fix some herb squares. Okay, that's the wrong direction as far as the down staircases go. I really need a crossbow, not a bow, though. That might still become a problem. Let's get those herbs before it's too late. Stomophilia isn't too bad. More bows. And secure some more herb squares. Yeah, that worked. That's another scroll. Already finished herb squares over here. Fortunately, I can't even do them. Can't even really do any herb farming. Okay, this is worrisome. Where are the down staircases? In normal circumstances, I should be able to easily see them. Ooh, that's a rust monster. Hey, change of plans. Your father smelled of elderberries. Please attack me. Ah, come. Damn it. My reaction was terrible on this one. And now my... Oh, dear. No, I don't actually have... Wait a second. I don't know. Hold that thought. Great. New spear. Did it just kill a rattling duelist for me? I didn't pay attention, really. I sense imminent danger. I have no idea what it stands for in this case. Right now, I'm not seeing anything dangerous. That's a comic lizard. They're easier to tell apart now. It's just one problem. I don't actually have all them a good way of damaging them. My gauntlets are coming back to haunt me. Best I can do is probably once. And I don't really want to. No. Get to that later. This place of beast would cost me a lot of turns to actually kill. I want a potion. Nope, no corpse from the Dark Sage. And there are stairs, and I'm one step closer to Dwarf Town. Well, if you need a crossbow, that's the best way to know that you're not going to get one. Chaos Brothers, huh? They give these very decent XP per pop. I'm going to just do it. Don't have a lot of HP anyway. And I don't think they can get past my armor. So, no worries here. It might be another uncursing scroll. I don't want to waste my time with stragglers. I'm down to 2,000 turns left, actually. That's not good at all. I want to make at least a dwarf town. I don't think level 12 is going to work out for me either. Sam is a strong farmer with a dog by his side wielding an ancient trident. You sense something of historical significance? I'm just going to assume that's the statues. Change in background music because there's an altar here. This one is neutrally aligned again, so I can actually sacrifice a good amount of my gold here. Drop my watery potions. Drop, for that matter, everything with items of unknown status without asking. Pick it all up again. That's good to know. I've got quite a bit of stuff that I can wield identify. Can actually read the scrolls. Oh well. Let's keep going. I should get the C at least. It's also definitely a good idea is to keep some gold for the shop. I might be able to buy a crossbow at least. The fact that I haven't found a crossbow earlier means that I haven't been able to train crossbows either. So the damage I'm gonna be doing with the quarrels might turn out to be rather limited anyway. But if I find a crossbow in the next 1,000 turns or so, there should be enough time to make them relevant. And either way, I'm still gonna have my tremendous blows. Though the lack of a really good weapon is also hurting me a bit here. Argue it's my own fault because I've sold pretty much. I've sacrificed the good weapons or better weapons I've found already. On the other hand, any orc worth his salt, orcish barbarian worth his salt, can murder 8 things with a spear. Unfortunately, this one with 21 strength is not really worth his salt after all. No shortage of herbs going on in this game. Man, I really want Dwarf Town now. It's not here, so it's on the next level. At least that's good to know. What's with me not managing to reach Dwarf Town? That's a bit disappointing. Wait a minute. Nope. Do not actually have one. Okay, no stairs in this room. Definitely not fire resistant. Quite unfortunate. Right, we're in Dwarf Town now. So first things first, obviously the most important part by far is to get into this shop and check the items. Potion of training. Pretty good. Not worth the money. Mithril halberd. The raw damage on this is very convincing. If I'm gonna have to get past PV with a melee weapon, it should be a good melee weapon. Is all I'm saying. Cloak of protection, very good. But I have to keep my money in case I get a godlike roll on anything. Doesn't look like it though. Ah, I know what Scrolls of Uncursing look like now. Well, that seems to be it. Is that rune? Oh, yeah. Of course, rune is always my own race. No, I did not, but please tell me more. Thank you. It's time to perform a big sale. No. Nah, I can try that on, I guess. No. Yeah. Nah. Rusty. Only need one. No. Climbing set. Nah, I'm gonna keep it. No. Please, no. No. Yes. No. Other people love Stomach Emptier. I don't really need one. No. I'm still strained. The solution would be to eat those large rations, and I can do that somewhere at some point down the road. What do I do now with the rest of the gold? Because I don't really need anything out of that shop. Oh yeah! I almost forgot that I had something to do here. Thundar! Yeah. Good to see a hero. Good to see you too. Slay a dark orc to prove your valor. I might actually be able to do that. Anyway. Select an item to dip. That's these gauntlets of so-and-so. Oh, freedom. Finally. I'm gonna sell them right away. I don't want any of that shit on my wrists. Oh, yeah. Nine. Well, whatever. You can have them for free for all I care. Nope, nothing really good around here. So I'm gonna spring for that Mithril Halberd after all. I wish I could read. But unless I found a Dark Orb very quickly, that's not gonna be an option. I'll be restricted to zapping these. no crossbow. I'm actually gonna have a hard time now. No crossbow. If only I had that crossbow, everything would be so much easier. Now it's gonna be tremendous blows and probable death. Well, I still have a good amount of time left. I'm gonna definitely... Shoplifters? There's a shop here? Why didn't I notice that before? I just don't pay attention anymore, I guess. White potion? Rust removal? It's the most useless imaginable shop for me. A scroll shop. Well, if I ever do learn to read, at least I will know what stuff is. It's a bit annoying. A lot of unknown scrolls there too. Anyway. No crossbows. Oh no, I don't want to go down, I want to go up. Value your time wasted this way. And if I keep doing stuff like that, I'm not gonna... Oh, large hammer. Oh. Let's some very respectable damage paired with a shield. I'm hoping that I'm gonna get some relevant training done before the day is done. I'm guessing it's a statue, but just for kicks, let's explore this corner of the revel. These guys only dropped the useless kind of crossbow, but I didn't like his face, so I had to kill him. Put a cloak. I already have a good cloak. Don't need another one. Oh, well, a worse one, actually. What's down here? Nothing. Okay, time for the big room, but I really won't be getting a lot of... Oh dear. Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit. I didn't pay attention. Now I'm cursed. That's super good. I'm a genius. And my turn's running out. I actually don't have time to train anymore. I have to face the music head on. Still, the damage is more than good enough at this point. This guy drops a corpse. I can go to be... Oh, holy crap. That is lucky. I have little skill of 13, literacy skill of 30 now. I don't even have to complete Thundar's quest to learn how to read anymore, which means I can now read my scrolls. One of the scrolls is a... I should have bought a blessed one at some point. Should have checked that scroll shop, but it's gonna have to do. I'm gonna bless that scroll of Identify. That should be a worthwhile use of that item. The potion of boost toughness is gonna come in very handy. I'm gonna definitely be reading that. The ones I own... None of them seems to immediately strike me as especially useful. I don't think they can be stunned. Steel Golem can be stunned. Though the Wand of Monster Detection is going to help me locate it, which might save me some valuable turns. With my scrolls... Oh! I should be able to abuse a Blessed Scroll for me summoning, except I can't really get to a place where there's going to be a useful monster coming out of it. The place would have been a Dwarven Halls, but they're long past now. I don't think I'm allowed to enter Darkforge proper to get myself a good familiar. Nah, I don't think it's possible. I can increase the melee accuracy of my hammer, and I'm actually crazy enough to be doing that. Potential willpower is always good. Gonna start eating those moncha roots as soon as I have room in my tummy. Spare crude spare in this place. Oh! I didn't see you there. Right, okay, let's talk about this. Come on! Don't keep some... Oh, holy crap, no, no! I'm out of here! Stupid cat! Out of my way! Oh, come on. Jesus Christ, I don't have time for this! Right. Okay, let's go. You can also straight to hell, I don't care. Just leave me in peace, right? Alright? Oh, come on, you don't want any of what I am right now. Oh, we bought some items. All for me? I'm so sorry. I shouldn't have been mean to you. I'm still getting used to these neutral ways. I'm at less than 500 turns before killing that. Yeah, I can absolutely waste no time now. No, I don't want to! Let me through. Passing through. No water. No, oh, I don't care. Passing through. Passing through. I can't actually... I have no time for anything. Cobalt Chief, yeah, I don't know. I don't care. Unless you have a crossbow. Which none of you have. Right, okay. I've got 300 turns. Roundabout. I've got around about 300 turns to get to the place where the steel golem is and actually kill it. I don't have tremendous blow. I'm well short of the 71,000 XP I would have needed to get there. So, it's gonna be large adamantium hammer and mighty blows to get past 35 points of PV on berserk mode. I'm detecting a considerable no way in hell factor from this entire thing. It's not, if I get ambushed by a shackle weir now, I'm gonna rage quit. Wait, where is it? There it is. Along a nondescript tunnel. Right. 350 turns left. After I have managed to kill the steel golem, I still have to make it back to the old barbarian glade. So, in order to not waste any time, first of all, I'm gonna drop everything I don't strictly need. Oh well, at least enough to get myself down to a decent enough level of weight. I'm not gonna take anything that won't help me at all. I'm gonna definitely switch out for a necklace of the eye. This will hold, but I'm gonna need a shield. I really am gonna need that shield. Can't really see myself making much use of those C's. Get it, C. Ah. Right, Mortar Roots. Nope, too late. Too late anyway. Right, okay. Okay, let's go. First of all, Zap. Wand of Monster Detection. The Steel Golem is this guy here. It's going to be a bit of a hike. Right, he's up there. Up and over here. Drink. Potion of Boost Toughness. I have one blessed potion of extra healing that might save my life several times over. Right. Where is it? Oh, come on. I have to walk around. I don't have to turn to spare. Okay, it's past here. Secret door. Okay, this key fits. Okay. I drank the potion way too early. And there's the spear golem. Well, it looks impressive. Right. This isn't gonna end well, really. Munchies, the Drakling Beast Fighter, played by, I think it was Cactus, managed to do the mission, but he was a Drakling and had the advantage of Acid Spit. So it was sure. So there was no doubt that he was able to do enough damage. I do not have any such advantage. I'm still unskilled in the hammer I found, but it's my best hope of doing damage while staying alive. I can switch to the halberd, which I'd have to bless first, because it's currently cursed. Although the difference wouldn't be that much anyway, because steel golems aren't demonic or anything. Which would do considerable amounts of more damage because of my weapon skill. Not that much. The two hit would be more remarkable. But I would feel the difference in defenses, because I've got a lot of DV. My DV is wrapped in that shield. Wrapped up in that shield. Right. Okay. Now, he's still at range, so I have one turn in which I can try something. Stun rays don't seem to work. Nope, they really don't. Alright. Mighty construct crafted from bright burnished steel. Each piece of it is masterfully crafted. Every motion is mechanical and precise. Joints turning smoothly and silently. A bright furnace heat radiates from its eyes. I really can't see this working. This is a YOLO swag kind of thing. Now, if I go berserk, I'm just gonna get obliterated melee. I can't really see it going in any way. But I might not do enough damage otherwise, so let's try and grab this. My melee damage is, on average, way too low. Even if it's doubled, thanks to Mighty Blow, it's gonna take something like 10 successful hits to kill it. Holy crap. That really looks bleak. Here goes nothing. Well, I did get past the PV, but so did he. What can I have spent sweet. I have spent sweet. Let's get some of that juicy spensweet on my skin. While I'm in coward mode, I have a reasonable enough chance that the golem won't kill me. Or hit me, at least. Now, he's probably going to hit me anyway if I want to do any damage. And I'm going to have to heal it up with the spensweet and my one potion of extra healing. So I'm going to go for berserk mode. And go for mighty blow again. That was a miss. I can't really afford them, but there they are. Go back to Spensweet. I should have blessed the heap of 10 cursed Spensweet, but it's a little bit too late now. Fire. I actually managed to dodge it, and fire is unlikely to kill me, so I'm not... It's really not going to make much of a difference if it breathes fire at me or tries to hit me in melee. It's both going to hurt. Well, I got myself some more weapon skill. Okay, some more damage was done. Let's use the spensweet again. Right now the damage is very survivable. I do have some armor. Woo! Yes! That was a critical hit. It doubled the double damage, which means I'm at quadruple damage at least, or something like that. And as you can see, I managed to exceed the 35 PV limit considerably and do enormous amounts of damage. That's the lucky break I needed, I think. It should be doable now. But let's keep the hell of my health up with Spensweet. In coward mode, my defenses are sufficient. It's almost done. I almost have it. Don't. Yep. Oh, holy crap. My last blessed spinsweet. I'm at full health again. Critically damaged. I don't even see a sliver of red. It must be at like 1 HP or something. Ladies and gentlemen, mission ADOMPossible 2 is a success. I even got level 11 out of it. Whew! Praise the Lord for Mighty Blow, is all I can say. Ooh, what, Shadow Lord? Whoa, 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 whoa. That's just mean. Holy crap! This guy's gonna kill me! I can't hit it! Run! Get away from me! Oh, come on, no. That would just suck. Be stunned. No. I insist. No. Come on. Oh, come on. DV of 32. Able to drain strength. Yeah, I'm already at 19. I would have had like 24 or something. Oh, Jesus. Ball sacks. What's that over there? That's a stone statue. I'm not gonna snatch defeat from the jaws of victory here, right? You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be shitting me. This is just unfair. No, come on. Don't do this to me. Oh, Jesus Christ, thank you. Oh, not you too. Nope, not. I have to eat petal petals. Die. This game just... it's just kicking my ass tonight. Yeah, I'm gonna shit on that food. I don't want it. Okay. Okay. Wilderness encounters. I really don't want... oh, no. Not a lag again. It's a bit of a shame that this is a public pre-release and for quite a while. But you're gonna have to deal with the lag, too. It makes wilderness encounters really tedious at this point. Oh well, the encounters are over already. I killed a stone golem in melee combat. I should be able to reach the barbarian's glade without dying a painful and embarrassing death. Like so. Jesus, ballsacks. Okay. Now, mission 2 of mission ADOMPossible actually has been a success. And I can breathe easy. Okay. Let's do some bookkeeping because I have some turns left. Get started with eating some mortar roots. I don't know. I mean, it's not like I have anything else to do. Oh! I never realized I had a necklace of rapid healing. That's actually awesome. And I never realized it because I'm stupid like that. But I don't care. I killed a steel golem. Let's make sure it actually appears in the kill list. Yep, there it is. Yep, I am officially done with this mission. Now, while we're at it, we can talk to the old barbarian here. Why not? Yo! Anybody home? No, I don't want to swim. I actually have the time to walk around for all the panic I've felt before. Actually, no, I don't. I'm running out of turns as I am trying to find the old barbarian to speak to, which is a bit of a shame. There he is. Sup, man?
Well met. A true warrior yard. Damn straight. Slay a score of the monster that was your first kill. If you manage that, come back. And I'll teach you something.
I think it was a bandit. I'm pretty sure it was a bandit, actually. So, do with that information what you will. I've got 5 turns left. I can spend 5 turns eating. 1, 2, 3, 4. Moja roots, and my last turn is going to be spent kicking the air in celebration. And hurting myself. Which is probably a pretty good summary of this turn. But we killed ourselves a steel golem. See you next time for the next mission ADOMPossible. This time with an entirely different character again.